Hello friends, in this video I'm going to show you how to create this kind of flashcard in minutes. So without any further ado, let's get started. First of all, I'm going to create a blank document and play with the layout. Let's click on layout section. On the left hand side there is margins. I don't want any margins, that's why click here custom margins. Let's just put it 0, 0, 0, 0. Every side we put 0 and hit OK to accept the changes. Let's change the orientation. On the left top hand side inside layout section there is an orientation, hit landscape. It looks much better. Now I can paste the text. Now choose whole text. Let's convert this text to a table. So let's go to the insert section. After selecting whole text, click on table, then convert text to table. Now this window will pop up. How many columns do you want? I want 2 columns. If you want 3, you can put there 3. I'm going to choose this auto fit to window section and hit OK to accept the changes. Looks much better, but it's ugly. Let's play with the text and the table design and it's going to look much better. First of all, let's play with the text. Let's go to the home section. And here, as you can see, there's different kinds of styling. Now it's normal right now. First of all, let's choose one of these texts and play the styling. On the left hand side, we can choose our fonts. Now I'm going to choose this free font, which is called Caveat Semi-Bold. To increase the size of the font, it looks much better. Also, I'm going to make sure that it's centered. Now also, I'm going to put some line spacing right there. It looks much better. You may want to change the color as well, if you really wanted to, but right now I don't. Now right click on the normal styling section and click this one, update normal to match selection. When I do it, it's going to update all normal styling. Now before I do that, I really wanted to show it. As you can see, this is normal styling and this one is normal too, and this one is normal too. You may want to choose different text to a different styling. I'm going to choose the text which I custom styled and then click on this one and update normal to match selection. As you can see, it's going to update whole text inside the document. Now it looks much better. Now let's choose the table. To choose whole table, click on this little icon right there and it's going to select whole table. Then let's go to the table design. Right now we have lots of borders right there. I don't want any borders right now. That's why on the right hand side, right top hand side, there's a border section. Check no borders and play with the border design. Let's put a little border just to the middle. So what I'm going to do, no border. Click on this one, then choose just inside borders only. It looks much better. Now let's play the flashcard size. How you can play with the flashcard size? Because it's inside the table, I'm going to play the layout inside the table. As you can see, there are 2 layout titles on here. This one is the document layout and this one is the table layout. Just click on this one and there is a distribution section. This is called height, and increase this one. As you can see, when I increase the height, it increased the table height, but only one side. To make sure that whole table is affected, just check whole table. Then increase the table size. Let's increase the table size. I want 2 flashcards. And as you can see, there is a little gap in here. If you really don't want this gap to be appeared in here, you can increase the height with the little numbers. You can put 2, 3, 4. You can, you know, practice to find the best number. I find that 4.7. It looks much better right now. Now the text, click on this one to make sure that the text is in the middle. Also, let's come to the layout section again. Let's put left indent 1 centimeter, right indent 1 centimeter to apply whole text. And let's increase the size of the text. Choose one of them, increase the size. Now choose normal and update normal. It's going to update whole text. I want a paper texture behind document. So how to do that? It's very easy. Go to design section. On the right top hand side, there is a page color. And then choose fill effects. Now this window will pop up. You can change the texture, pattern, or you may want to add picture. In this video, I'm going to add a picture. So select the picture. This window will pop up. You can search whatever you want. I'm going to search for paper, hit enter, and it's going to find different types of paper images. For this video, I'm going to choose this one and hit insert to accept the changes and hit OK to accept the changes again. Now our flashcard is ready. I hope this video helped you guys. If it does, hit the like button and comment down below to motivate me and help other people to know that actually this video is a great match for them. Bye-bye.